Hello, Lock Jockey here. I've got a quick set smart key I'm gonna pick for you. All right, open. Pain in the butt. Not sure why it keeps going out of focus like that. So this lock is super finicky to me. It's actually a really great lock for what it's worth. You know, you're able to quickly rekey it with this little insert tool right here in this hole right there. Let's get this thing taken apart though. Sidebar springs. I'm really gonna try more often to pick at this thing since you're able to quickly key it. You know, change the bitting on it. It's actually not bad. Not 100% familiar with the parts that are inside of this thing. See how the sliders sit in there. I keep calling them sliders. I think they're sliders though. You can see the false gates and the true gate right there. Oops. For a $10 cylinder, that's all these little replacement plugs are, replacement cylinders. They have a decent, you know, a decent level of security. Except that if you put too much force on these, you're able to damage all of the internals pretty easily. This is the reset here. Very interesting. These guys are pretty cool. $10, $12, and you get a cheap, quickly recombinated lock with the sidebar. So for Locksport, it's a pretty good deal. So how I learned the lock, which probably wasn't a good display of me learning the lock, but how I learned it was I cut a couple of keys. At first, I started with all sixes, so I could feel the difference between what the feedback was. So if you remove the equation of various pin heights, all you really have left is feedback. So that there was nothing to it. All sixes got the lock open really, really fast. Couldn't really get a sense of feedback there. This one, probably you get a better sense of feedback, and these are all twos. So you'd have to lift each slider up to a two position. But so in order to do that, you can either lift one all the way up individually or click, you know, per false gate. So this seemed to be the key to better learn what the feedback was. So when you're at a certain height and you know you're set, then that's the height you have to match for all of these. So like I said, you're taking the height out of the equation. All you're left with is feedback. So maybe not the right way. It helped for me. And then I worked with this bidding for a little bit. But I wanted to use a factory cut key, which is this one. This one came with the actual cylinder replacement, which comes in a bag like this. But awesome. Thanks for watching.